Do you use any kind of herbicide or pesticide here on your farm?
No, but since we've been pretty candid on this program, I think I'll be candid again. My place here is called Herbal Vineyard. Notice I haven't shown you a grape. They're tucked away here and there, but I planted this, called this place Herbal Vineyard, thinking I was going to grow grapes organically. And I got over 100 varieties of grapes, most of them newfangled varieties, and I interplanted them with these strongly aromatic herbs that are supposed to keep disease and insects away. And I failed completely. I bet I wouldn't get a 2% return on the fruits, but mostly because I had newfangled varieties, and these newfangled varieties are pesticide dependent. Mm-hmm. But I, Jim Duke, am not pesticide dependent. There's been no pesticide used on this farm since one of my sharecroppers left, but it's clean for the last 3 years. But I've got old-fashioned varieties of grapes down on the side of the hill with these herbs, and they're bearing quite well. I'll get a 50% return on those. And my apples, you know, there'll be one side that's bad and another side that's good. I don't use pesticides because if that bug doesn't want to eat the apple or the grape, neither do I. So I sacrifice 50% of my grapes and can go down the row and eat them right off the vine without having to wash them, which is a real pleasure on a hot August afternoon.
Yeah. And you have corn growing out behind your barn?
I have an American Indian patch back there where I've got corn, beans. I didn't plant potatoes back there. I got peppers, my favorite thing, cornbread and beans and homegrown tomatoes. That's another of the great gifts of the American Indian butt south of our border. Mm-hmm. There's a little okra, which is not from America back there, but I've even got a primrose pass. Evening primrose is one that I think alternative croppers will hear a lot about. There's a newly developing market for that in the health food market. It contains this so-called essential fatty acid, gamma-linolenic acid. And I'm growing it down there. My path leads right on into the shade to see if I can get as much seed yield in the shade as I do out in the sunshine. Because in general, gamma-linolenic acid, the farther north you go, the higher the percentage of that will be in a given oil, such that if I cloned my evening primrose and grew some in North Carolina, some in Maryland, and some in Canada, that in Canada would have a higher percentage of this magic ingredient, the gamma-linolenic acid. And I think that shade might affect the proportions as well. But my primrose path, I hope to have with many, many more varieties next year. But that's just the old weed evening primrose back there now.
It seeds itself and is relatively easy to grow.
Yeah, so does the Sweet Annie. My wife still regrets the day that I brought Sweet Annie home. It's taken over parts of the area.
What's the interest in the evening primrose? What occasions
the interest? The gamma-linolenic acid, which is in the seed oil. Mm-hmm. As a matter of fact, North Carolina grew over 400 acres last year, and Oregon grew over 400 acres. The seeds were shipped to England. The oil was squeezed out and put in gelatin capsules and sent back to our health food markets. And I'm sorry you asked that. One of the reasons it's taken is for premenstrual syndrome. Uh-huh. And I've been eating the seeds for 5 years, and I haven't had PMS yet.
Efficacious.
proof of the pudding, eh? They also say it's good for obesity, and I can't prove it.
Well, I want to thank you for inviting us out here to your farm, and I wanted to ask you, because I was down at Monticello last weekend, and I heard what Jefferson wanted to be remembered for, and it occurred to me in talking to you today, I would like to ask you, although you're not through your career, you've certainly had a lot of interesting and wonderful things that you've done and discovered. What would you like to be remembered for?
Something I haven't done yet. And that's I would like to be remembered for turning around the trend from the natural medicine to the synthetic medicine. I think we made a mistake there, because through evolution, my genes and my immune system have already experienced all the poisons that are here in this garden, or many of them, because my grandparents' grandparents ate or used these things for one thing or another, such that my genes have already touched those poisons. My genes have not experienced tomorrow's synthetic. 200 years ago, all of our medicines were natural. Today, still, 25% of prescription drugs are based on higher plants, and almost half of prescription drugs are based on lower plants, higher plants, and animals. So that even today, 50% of our, almost 50% are natural. I would like to see that go back to 100%. I really believe that the natural is safer than the synthetic, or at least many of the synthetics.
Well, I hope if that's what you want to happen, that it happens. And I think that whoever called you a Renaissance man was right on. Thank you.
Good to see you, Jenny. Welcome to the woods.
Thank you. The old guy keeps hanging on. The wine, the women, the song. Sometimes he cries as he tries to keep singing on. He's too weak. The wine's too strong.
Never ceased to be amazed how the shack where I was raised kept me tied to my mama's apron string. Then the whole thing fell apart when my daddy broke her heart and he left the mountain on a plane. Appalachian rain, don't you rain on me again. I done got the blues on the run. Appalachian snow, don't you show me no more. I'm gonna take my love in the sun. We were much too young to wed, but that's what her daddy said. Much too green to be a mom and dad. So the knot was tied too soon. Appalachian honeymoon swept away the little love we had. Appalachian rain, don't you rain on me again. I done got the blues on the run. Appalachian storm, don't you show me no more. I'm gonna take my love in the sun. When you love a mountain girl, there can't be a better world.
You smile till there's raindrops in your eyes. But when you leave the mountain wide, you done turned your back on life. With each raindrop, a piece of you dies. All alone now on the plains, started crying mountain rain. Appalachia's calling me again. The wolf, he howled no end, how you can't go home again. The chimney is all that now remains.